will be nothing without lighting. To have a beautiful home, you need the perfect light installed in the right way. Today in the Homes and Construction Affairs show, we are going to handle which lights are for outdoor and which lights are for indoor. My name is Hilda Kamkama. If I have a bedroom, do I have to use the same light as the one in the sitting room?
Not necessarily, but it depends. Every house and every room and space and the size of the space has different requirements. You may have a living room light and someone puts it in a bedroom. But when you realize, before you thought that what you have in your living room is too big for a bedroom, but then you realize someone's bedroom is as big as your house. So it depends on how which space you are having, but though we always don't recommend a living room light to be exactly the same as a master bedroom, because these are two different spaces. Here is a communal space for everyone, the other is your resting area. So it's always different, you do something different for each spaces. Yes, please.
For starters, I know my viewers out there would like to know which light they should consider, especially when they are in like a sitting room.
This consideration you always take when you're going to put which lights where depends on the height of the ceiling first. If your height is okay, is reasonably okay, or maybe 3 meters plus, you can always use a pendant light, the one which is longer. For example, we can look at this lamp. If you have a ceiling which is short, you cannot use such a light. Reason being, you are going to hang it on the ceiling and you're going to find it on the floor. Now such lights, we are looking at someone who has a house, maybe with a void. You have built your storied house, you have a double ceiling sitting room, you can use such a lamp. You can use such a light for such spaces because it's long. From floor to ceiling, it's long. You can use this, but if you're looking at your space being short, you're having like 2.5 meters to 3 meters, we always prefer lights that are ceiling hugging, the ones that sit on the ceiling, because you don't want something that's going to come and again obstruct your entire sitting room. However, even if it's 3 meters, you can use a pendant light, but with a low chain. You don't go for something that is extremely so low.
Do you have such a kind of light that we look at?
So we have such lamps. If you look at this, for example here, that shine area here, the white, that silver light, you can use that one for a living room. It can work perfect for a dining room, depending on the spaces as we had talked. If it's a big sitting room, that can do perfectly. If it's a dining room, it can do perfectly. However, what we can always do is such, you adjust towards the ceiling, you reduce the chains. But if your ceiling is completely low, you will definitely need to look for a lamp that is ceiling hugging. If your ceiling is low, you look for a ceiling hugging light. For example, we can look at the chandeliers up, not this.
Something like that one.
Something
and this well. One.
This is as well.
But this is not low hanging.
The height is perfect, it's okay, because here they are hanging low. But even if the height is not so long, it can still perfectly do. Because at the end of the day, much as it is long, if you realize that your chandelier is coming low, we always create a center table so that it is taking up the space where you have a center table in the middle of your living room. But still, if you don't have the privilege of having even a center table because the room is small, you will definitely have to opt for a light that is ceiling hugging, perfectly ceiling hugging. We can look at some of them here. We have some here, a lamp like that will sit onto the, will embed purely onto the ceiling. These are perfect lights for low ceiling houses. So if your house ceiling is low, we always recommend lights that are ceiling hugging. Something like these are okay. However low that ceiling is, even if it's 2 meters, definitely at the end of the day you need some light.
Wait a minute, you want to tell me that I can use this kind of light on, like, in a sitting room?
Perfectly, yes.
Really?
Some houses are small, some houses are big. But of course, you're looking at using something small, this is about 35 centimeters wide, so it's not something very big. So we are looking at a space that is not very big, so that one can perfectly do in a space that is not so big. Our small houses. But if the bigger the house goes, the bigger you're looking at the lamp and the amount of light to be more than the previous spaces we are talking about, the small spaces.
I have seen places where they have more than one light, like a species of different lights in a sitting room. In that case, how do you advise?
That is possible still, but we would not recommend having too much mix and blend. It's always better, if you go one version. Some spaces you always find like maybe they have put up a storied house and their beams, maybe a T-beam, and each side, each quadrangle is accommodating a light. A T-beam is, if this is a slab, where the beam that is holding the entire structure, the upper roof structure is meeting. So you'll find if it crosses one another, it creates kind of a T. And you find the other quadrangle and there are four quadrangles created. So you may not be able to have the privilege of putting a center light in the middle. So you find some people putting four lights within a sitting room. However, that one we would recommend you use a slightly very small light, not so huge, because you're going to have four in the same living area. So if you fit something very big, it will look overcrowded and the light will be too much and you'll not be also comfortable. It's a home, not a showroom at the end of the day. So you look for something that is going to, you know, to communicate with the surrounding, with your spaces, and your comfort at the end of it. So yeah, basically that. So ceiling, when you're looking at a living room, you're looking at all the entire house. How tall is the house? If it's, the height is really not so big enough, what we always do, we recommend ceiling hugging lights. If it's low, we use the one that's getting off ceiling. That's for a living room. Dining, we always look at pendant lights. The pendant is the one that is getting off ceiling. It's not ceiling. It's not seated on the ceiling. There you look at that. It is hanging. It's going to hang. Because the pretext at the end of it, we are looking at it hanging around the center, the dining table. So dining is not always beautiful with a ceiling hanging light. It is perfect with the pendant, kind of. The one that is getting off the ceiling and coming down.
May I have this one also on a dining?
This is perfect for dining. I've done some houses with this and they look so amazing. So we can increase the height slightly, we can reduce it slightly depending on the house, on your ceiling, float ceiling. So that is perfect for dining. Kitchen as well, we can use such pendant lights. We can use all these. And these are always used like in the kitchen. These days when they're doing kitchens, you always find there's a kitchen island. Now a kitchen island, you find it's a table, and you always find we always put maybe 2 to 3 lamps, which are 1, 2, 3. So those are always
clear light.
Yeah, and it looks like even the design looks better with that. So we always look for a single pendant, because imagine you're putting three in the same space, and each one has three bulbs, three. That's too much. So we always use either 1, 2, or 3 in single pendants. So that's always the kitchen space. But then as you put the single, if you have an island and you put the single pendants, we always think about things like spotlights to enhance the light for around the whole kitchen area.
Now show me the spotlights.
This entire section are spotlights. So this one, what it helps you with, it enhances the light. Yeah, much as it is, I think now that is the trendy way of building houses with gypsum. If you don't have gypsum, you can still use the spotlights. We can show you how it is done. If you're constructing a storied house and you want purely for the whole house to have spotlights and you don't want to use gypsum in future, there's a way we do it. So we can recommend someone to help you on that. The engineers always lay them in the slab before casting the slab. But with the measurement of the very spotlight, which you are thinking about using in future. So you come and get a sample, you get a small mold, that's what they could keep installing. They install in the slab layout before casting. So when they finish casting and you're doing your final touches, those holes remain. So you come and just install the spotlight. It will look like you're having a gypsum, but when it's not available.
Now you talked about the gypsums. Can I have a gypsum and at the same time have a wall hanging light in a sitting room?
Perfectly. It's supposed to actually look like that. Why are you opting for gypsum? Gypsum is fancy, is neat, is clear, is simple to install, and looks very executive. So when you have a gypsum, depending on the person has done for your gypsum board, you can have your gypsum on the sides of the house, for example, and even in the center. Not so much a congested design. So you'll have an option of having a spotlight. You're going to have an option of having the strip light, which we call the running lights. I will show you how the illumination looks like. Then you can have your center light. Center light, sometimes when you have gypsum and you have spotlight and strip light, the center light is more of a deco item. It's a deco piece. You can have an option of having it lighting at one time, but it's not like when I have gypsum and I need spotlight and I need strip light, do I really need a center light? Center light at that moment, we are looking at it as a deco item. it's something of beauty. It can light, it gives value to the room. So basically you can have all in one. However, when they are doing the wiring, we don't put all the lights at once. Spotlights will have a different gang. We call them gangs. So the switch is putting on center light.
So the gang is kind of like a control.
Exactly. So I can have, maybe for example, if I look here, this one has one gang, two gang, three gang, four gang, Lighting City brand. So I can say, this one is my center light. This one is my wall lights. This one is for my strip light. Then this one is my bedside lamp or something. So you may have so many of them in the same living area, but it does not necessarily mean that when you're going to switch them on, they are going to come on at the same time. So they're just a thing of beauty. It's just something beautiful. So basically that.
How is the corridor supposed to be?
Corridors, we are looking at how tall the place is, but most of the time corridor, we are looking at something that is going to give you light. To pass, to go to where you're going. Next episode, where
can
you go?
Put a chandelier in a corridor?
Yes, you can. People put chandeliers and their places look nice. But how big is the place? You find that you have a corridor of 1 meter. You can't put a corridor of 1 meter, you can't have a chandelier. Because if you put it there, it's going to look funny.
So in other words, the space determines the kind of lighting you're going to...
Perfect. That space determines the kind of light you're going to have. If you have a small area like for corridors, these are okay. These ones, we call them panel lights. Please, you see they're small, they're not so big. Yeah, LED panel lights. However, this, if you look at their sizes, this one is 6 watts, this is 12 watts, this is 18 watts, in different shapes and color.
So are they supposed to go in a row?
No. Yeah, it's just a display. Oh. But if I have a small corridor, for example, I can use a 6 watts. If your corridor is slightly bigger than mine, you can use a 12. The bigger it goes, the more brightness the illumination comes in. So you can use this for a small corridor. It's slightly bigger, you can use a 12 watt. If it's very big, you can go for this, for 18 watts. These lights work in corridors, in bathrooms, in sheds, in toilets. Some areas for people are very economical, you find they are put in the bedrooms, and it's okay. So it's a costly thing, less than 30,000. So it's something very affordable for a whole, yes, exactly. You have your LED, it doesn't have a bulb, it is clear illumination of light, it is very bright, it is neat, it is fancy, it is executive, it is something recent. So you can have something like that. So when you're looking at lighting the house, I can look at the chandelier, for example, of slightly more price, maybe 300,000 or something, depending on your budget. I look at the sitting room, I spend slightly more because I want it to look more fancy. Dining, I spend slightly more because I want it to look fancy. Then master bedroom, I look at it. Also, I want it fancy because that's why I sleep, the owner of the house. Then the other spaces, what you can look at is, can I cut down the budget?
Yes.
So if my money is running low, I can opt for such 30,000, 40,000. The house is lit properly, but the major usable spaces are perfectly and well aligned with the lighting, because that's the first deco item you're going to have in your house. So basically, you just have to look at that. When you're spending, you look at the sitting room, first priority, because that's where everyone is coming in. Number two, we're looking at the dining. Because from sitting room, these days the houses we're building are open concept. From sitting room, dining, kitchen. So I spend slightly more on the sitting room. Then I go to the dining, spend slightly more. Then I look for master bedroom. Then the other spaces, I can look at how good is my budget. If it's very good, you can go ahead and do your extremely fancy everywhere.
Apparently, we've seen different building concepts. And we have the studio houses.
Studio apartments.
You know, studio apartments. Now, everything is there, one at a go, the kitchen, bedroom. Which lights do you recommend?
What I would recommend for a studio, given that it's an open area concept, why are they putting up studio apartments, for example? There are so many corporates, they want to sleep near town, the cost is slightly high. So you find maybe there are 20 houses in one. So sitting room, dining, kitchen, is everything around, then they got bedroom. So given that a sitting room and a dining and a kitchen, it's one from one to another, they're in the same space. When you're trying to do that concept, we do one concept. We try to match all of them.
Okay, briefly take us through how you can manage that.
All right. Now I look, for example, let me think about having black leather. That's my theme. So I'm going to look at a black, like for the living room. I will think about a lamp or light or chandelier that is black. Remember, these spaces are small,
yes.
From one to another.
Yes.
So definitely, given that the dining area is directly next to the living room, I need a component of luck within that, as well as the kitchen, because these spaces are running from one to another. But sometimes you find someone has put a golden chandelier in the sitting room, then the dining has put a gray black, and then you find. So we always work within the same space, but try to rhyme the concept. The wall lights, the center lights, the space, if the space is the same, you don't go off concept. So we look at roughly the same color, roughly the same concept, not exact, but matching ones. So that's what I was looking for. If it's a studio apartment, because it's one space, we always try to look for within. Maybe living room can have slightly bigger, dining slightly smaller, kitchen, because also those kitchens are very small, so slightly smaller. That would be a perfect concept, yeah.
Let's talk about the bedroom, because now this is every lady's spot. And I know many of my ladies want to know how to deal with their bedrooms.
Our bedrooms? Also, it depends. It's always the way we talked about it. It's a match and mix. What do you love most? That is one. No, I'm like the client. What do they love most? What their budget can accommodate at the end of it. So bedrooms, you always find. Most people like these kind of lights, which have modes. If you look at this, it has three color modes. We have cool white. It can give you white light. If you switch off and on, it gives you the warm white. Yeah. If I switch off and I switch on, it gives you cool white. If I switch off and on, it's going to give you daylight. So some people always, for different reasons, they prefer a certain kind of mode. So it gives you a mode. So most people prefer such lights because in the bedroom, everyone has their, you know, you have had your emotions during the day, the errands were too much, and maybe you don't want to look at yourself so much, you want to see yourself with a different color and you've not yet put makeup, so you can put on any mode. So that's what always people are always looking at. But we are not saying that it's only limited to such kinds of lights. You find someone has taken a chandelier, which someone else opted to put in the sitting room for their bedroom.
Yes.
Because their bedroom space is slightly, maybe different or bigger or fancy or something, or even the budget they can afford. So it's so many different concepts. So we always look at that, and that's what we determine from.
Now, I'm diverting you briefly from where we're going. These lights that have three themes, how friendly are they pocket-wise?
They are very cheap items, as less as maybe 50,000, as less as 100,000. So they are very affordable.
Wow.
Very cheap. They are not expensive. Only that when people look at them when they're displayed, they look for the fancy and extremely expensive.
And they're like, no, I'm not going for that because I believe what it costs, I don't have it.
No, the cost is very cost friendly. Actually, when you realize you end up finding a saving more than what you're fearing, what you don't know, come in and ask. They're going to give you prices and you're not even believe it. And the lifespan is perfect. So when you're looking at what you're going to do, just come in and consult. If you consult with the people who know, it's not something really so much. Only that sometimes when people look at them, they're like, can I buy something from that showroom? They're extremely very affordable and extremely very cheap.
Now, apart from these ones, do you have any other lights that you may or you can recommend for a bedroom?
So many. I can have this chandelier for my bedroom. This is a very beautiful piece.
Seriously?
Yes. There's the other chandelier there. The one that looks like a ring. That's a very beautiful light for the bedroom. Three modes as well. I can have daylight. I can switch off and on. Then you get white light. Then you get cool white. So basically, as we had said, it depends on the space. So most of the time, people in the they don't like a lot of light in the bedroom. So sometimes you end up finding how big the room is how big the light you're going to look for. So the bigger the light, most of the time, the more illumination it gives. So the light will be so much. So basically, you have to look at the size before. Which light can I put where? Which light can I put here? I have a colleague who put a very huge chandelier. The other one, you see, in a closet. Then someone says, how can you go to a closet? Is it a hotel? Yeah, it's not a hotel. Some people's homes look like hotels. So the dreams are different. The ambitions are different. And, you know, everyone has something they like. So it's not hotel-like. It's people who sleep in hotels. The owners of the hotels have homes, and they want them to look like hotels. And the budget, they can afford it. And it's not that much. So it's a match made. You go for what you like, what you can afford. And the prices are really not scary at all.
So for like a standard bedroom, honey, putting outside these lights, the main ones you've given us, can you also share with us more other types of lights we can have?
Sure, we can. We can look at this. This can be a very beautiful bedroom lamp. If you look at this one.
Is it also, does it have themes, different themes as well, or it's just?
Yeah, they do have themes. This one has, you put in a bulb, but still we have the bulbs that do the themes, the way I showed you the other one, three color. And very cheap, as about 10,000 a bulb. So you have that and you have the three themes in one. So you can have this, all this can do, we can have something like this for bedroom. This is a little vintage. Some people, it attracts a certain class of people. Yeah.
Which is fine.
Definitely, because all of them have requirements. This is more elegant, so most people prefer something like this because it's more modern, and you know, it creates excitement. And so we can always look at any item. This is okay. You can do this in the bedroom. However, with such, you always have to look at a bedroom ceiling that is slightly up. It has to be, because you see, it's a bit long. And you find sometimes maybe someone has a net. Some people use nets, and maybe it is colliding with the light. So that's why most of the time you're looking at a lamp that is sitting on the ceiling.
Oh, okay.
To avoid that collision between the chandelier and the net. So you basically have to first look at your space, what you have, and then as we are interacting during the purchase, then we advise. Oh, this one you like it, but you have a net. So how are you going to put it? Are you going to cut it into half? So I say, no, we can opt for option B, option C. For a high ceiling, I can go for this. This is a beautiful home high ceiling lamp. But if for example, I fear it's going to collide with a net, I can take you to another option that is almost the same. Now, this is a different version, but of a ceiling light. So even if you have, if you look at it, same concept as well. Switch off, on, it gives you warm white. Switch off and on, gives you that, then gives you the light.
Edgar, I'm seeing that light now. Where is it advised to be installed?
This one?
Yes.
This one you can use in the dining room. So it depends on the spaces you have. I've had people have used it as a living room area, but me, I've used it as on the reception of Lighting City. So it depends. We always look at the spaces. How big is it? You may love it when you put it in your space. It looks over congested. So you can have it anywhere. Though there are spaces they can't work, like a kitchen, because the light intensity is not that much. It can work in the bedroom. It can work, but depending on our spaces. We're always looking at the size vis-a-vis what we are putting. So basically that. Even these ones you can use in a bedroom. Some people buy these for bedrooms, these small ones. They look small. Some people use in the kitchen. They use in the sitting room. But we have people come and buy them for their corridors. You'd be like, no, that's too much. When you go to install, you realize like, wow, the light they bought for a corridor is too small. So it depends.
When we talk about light, we can go on and on and on. But we are taking a short break and coming back because we promised you to give you everything that you may want to know about lighting.